Dear friend, welcome to the lecture series in antennas and wave propagation. In today's lecture, we are going to learn about array of two point sources with equal amplitude and phase. Coming to array of two point sources with equal amplitude and phase, let us consider two isotropic point sources which are kept symmetrical with respect to origin as shown in the below figure. Now these two point sources are separated by a distance d, and we are considering the Cartesian coordinate system. Now we would like to find out the field at the distance point p. Now from the origin to the point sources, the distance is considered as d by 2. Now when the point sources 1 and 2 are provided with the currents of equal magnitude and in phase, then we observe that the waves which are generating from point 2, that is source 2, is reaching the distance point p earlier than the waves from the point source 1. For the analysis purpose, let us draw the normal lines to the radius vector line. Now considering the angle theta and indicating the points 1 dash, 2 dash, so that the 1 dash, 2 dash will be considered as the path difference here. Now the distance between 1 dash and the origin O and from origin to the 2 dash will be equal to d by 2 cos theta. So individually the distances will be equal to d by 2 cos theta as well as d by 2 cos theta. Now the path difference between two waves is given by the path difference 1 dash 2 dash will be equal to d by 2 cos theta plus d by 2 cos theta in meters. Now when we add these two terms, we get d cos theta. If we would like to represent the d cos theta in terms of wavelength, so that we can write this one as d by lambda cos theta wavelength. From the optics, phase angle is 2 pi times the phase difference, so that the phase angle psi will be equal to 2 pi of path difference. So here the phase angle psi will be equal to 2 pi of the path difference that we can write as d by lambda cos theta radians. Now we just rewriting this expression, then we get psi equal to 2 pi by lambda d cos theta in radians. We know that beta will be equal to 2 pi by lambda. So here 2 pi by lambda will be replaced with beta, so that psi will be equal to bd cos theta in radians. Now let E1 will be the for electric field at a distance point P due to the source 1, and E2 is the for electric field at distance point P due to source 2, and E will be the total electric field at the point P. Now the psi is the phase angle difference measured between the two fields from source 1 and source 2 along the radius vector line. The total for electric field at a point P in the direction of theta is E will be equal to E1 e power minus j psi by 2 plus E2 e power j psi by 2. Let us consider this one as equation 1. Here E1 e power minus j psi by 2 is the field component due to the source 1. E2 e power j psi by 2 is the field component due to source 2. Assuming the amplitudes of the fields from both sources are equal, that is when the two point sources have been provided with the equal magnitudes of the current, so that we are considering the fields generated from those point sources are also equal in magnitudes. So therefore E1 which is equal to E2 will be equal to E0. Let us consider those magnitudes are E0 now from equation 1. So E will be equal to E0 e power j psi by 2 plus E0 e power j psi by 2. Taking E0 as common, so E will be E0 of e power j psi by 2 plus e power j psi by 2. Multiplying and dividing with 2 to the above expression, we get E equal to 2 E0 of e power minus j psi by 2 plus e power j psi by 2 by 2. Writing e power minus j psi by 2 plus e power j psi by 2 by 2 equal to cos psi by 2, then E will be equal to 2 E0 cos psi by 2. Since psi can be written as beta d cos theta as it is the phase angle, Now we can write E equal to 2 eta naught cos BD cos theta by 2. And let us consider this one as equation number 2. E here indicates the total for electric field due to two point sources with equal amplitude and same phase. And this indicates the amplitude and this term indicates the phase. Now the maximum value of 2 eta naught is equal to 1. So we can write 2 eta naught will be equal to 1. So eta naught will be equal to 1 by 2. If beta equal to 2 pi by lambda and the distance between the point sources is considered as lambda by 2, then the equation 2 becomes E equal to 2 of 1 by 2 of cos of 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 2 into cos theta by 2. When we simplify this expression, we get E equal to cos of pi by 2 cos theta. Now considering this one as equation 3, and this indicates the for electric field pattern equation. Now we are going to find the maxima radiation loop directions. So from equation 3, the expression of E is maximum when cos of pi by 2 cos theta is maximum. So the maximum values considered as plus or minus 1 here. Writing cos of pi by 2 cos theta will be equal to plus or minus 1. Now pi by 2 cos, now theta changes to theta max, which is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1. Pi by 2 cos theta max will be equal to plus or minus n pi now. The values of n will be from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. If we consider n equal to 0, then pi by 2 cos theta max will be equal to 0, then cos theta max will be equal to 0, then theta max will be equal to cos inverse of 0, so that cos inverse of 0 will be available at 90 degrees as well as at 270 degrees. So this particular directions will provide that the maximum radiation directions. Now finding minima radiation loop directions from equation 3 again, E is minimum when cos of pi by 2 cos theta is minimum. So the minimum value that is considered is 0. Therefore, E is minimum when cos of pi by 2 cos theta is equal to 0. Now, the theta changes to theta minimum, then pi by 2 cos theta minimum will be equal to cos inverse of 0. Now, the cos inverse of 0 can be written as plus or minus 2 n plus 1 multiplied with pi divided by 2. Now, the values of n will be considered as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. For n equal to 0, we get pi by 2 cos theta minimum, which is equal to plus or minus pi by 2. Now, cos theta minimum will be equal to plus or minus 1. Taking the cos term towards the right side, so we will be getting theta minimum equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1. Now, cos inverse of plus or minus 1 will be giving us 0 degree and 180 degrees. So this particular answer tells us that the minimum radiation occurs in 0 and 180 degrees direction. Coming to finding the half power point direction of the field, at half power points, the power is half, that is 1 by 2, or voltage or current is 1 by root 2 times the maximum value of the voltage or current. So therefore, from equation 3, so cos of pi by 2 cos theta will be equal to plus or minus 1 by root 2. Now pi by 2 cos, then theta is changed to half power point direction, which is equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1 by root 2. So this particular thing will be provided as plus or minus 2 n plus 1 multiplied with pi by 4. So here the values of n will be considered as 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. And for n equal to 0, pi by 2 cos theta HPPD equal to plus or minus pi by 4. Now cos theta HPPD will be equal to plus or minus 1 by 2. Then theta HPPD will be equal to cos inverse of plus or minus 1 by 2, so that the angle values will be available as 60 degrees and 120 degrees when we compute this. Now looking at the radiation pattern, so we have the x-axis as well as the y-axis. Now we are getting the maximum radiation pattern in the 90 degrees as well as the 270 degrees. Now this is the field radiation pattern which is maximum in the theta 90 and theta 270 degrees. And in theta equal to 0 degrees and 180 degrees, the radiation is minimum, that is almost zero in ideal case. and we are having the half power point directions in 60 degrees and as well as in 120 degrees. Coming to the conclusions, in this video tutorial, we have learned that the psi will be equal to 2 pi f d by lambda cos theta radians, and the electric field expression at the distance point is given as cos of pi by 2 cos theta, and it is the field pattern. And the maximum direction of radiation is in 90 degrees and 270 degrees, and the minimum radiation is in 0 and 180 degrees. Here, the point sources, two point sources with equal amplitude as well as the phase, is the simplest form of the broadside array, and it is also known as the broadside couplet. Hope you understood the video on the two point sources with equal amplitudes in phase. Do subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will be notified with the latest videos in antennas and wave propagation. Thanks for watching.